Imagine if you were given the mission to capture the most prolific drug dealer in the entire world. In tonight's brand new episode of Declassified, we look at the untold story of how the DEA brought down a so-called heroin godfather with ties to the Taliban. Here's a preview.
This is an area with a tradition of growing a lot of poppy. There's mountainous clandestine labs there, so a lot of the heroin is produced in these areas. There's definitely a handful of large players, but Haji Bagcho would be one of the largest heroin dealers in Afghanistan.
Our sources were telling us that he was dealing in opium and heroin back into the early 1990s.
Haji Bagcho's organization is extensive.
He had hundreds of people working for him.
He had individuals that were growing poppy, converting it into the opium. There were laboratories where it was processed by chemists. He had individuals that were in charge of transporting product out to various countries. He was a criminal mastermind.
He had offices in Pakistan, he had offices in Afghanistan, and he had distribution networks in 22 countries around the world.
It became clear that Haji Bagcho was kind of the godfather. He was really the man in the shadows that was in charge. The other people that were more well-known, they kind of worked for him.
The money that he was making, the profits, were going into houses, they were going into vehicles. A significant portion of it was going to support terrorism. It was going to the Haqqani network, it was going to the Pakistan Taliban, and to the Afghan Taliban. There's untold numbers of people who died because of that heroin. And the money that was being generated from those heroin sales was going to people that wanted to destroy the United States.
Joining me now is a member of the DEA team that hunted down the world's biggest heroin trafficker, former supervisory agent, special agent, Jeffrey Higgins. Jeffrey, thank you for coming on. Give us a sense of what it took to capture this man by who all accounts was a criminal mastermind.
Well, he was the most prolific heroin trafficker and overall drug dealer in the world. He was responsible for 19.7% of the world's heroin, and he made at least a minimum of $261 million in a 12-month period from 2006 into 2007. And the kind of money that Haji Bagcho made when it went overseas, like, we know that 10 to 12% of the heroin in the United States comes from Afghanistan. And the difference in pricing between Afghanistan and the United States is incredible. You can buy a kilo of heroin in Afghanistan for $2,100, and it goes for close to $70,000 in the United States. So the money in this country was in the hundreds of millions of dollars as well. So you're talking about someone who had incredible influence with politicians, with the police, with the military, and also with all the business and people we had to deal with in Afghanistan. So the people in eastern Afghanistan were terrified of him.
Wow, that's unbelievable. I know the DEA suspected Haji Bagcho of paying the Taliban to protect his opium labs. How much money does the Taliban actually get from drug trafficking, and how exactly are those funds utilized?
Well, the UN Office of Drugs and Crime estimated in their 2017 World Drug Report that the Taliban had upwards of $400 million in funding, and as much as half of that came from drug sales. So you have opiate sales, meaning opium that comes from the poppy plants in Afghanistan, morphine and heroin that's being sold there. And it's also the highest concentration of terror groups in the world. When President Trump made his speech a couple of weeks ago outlining his new Afghan policy, he talked about this concentration. You know, you have Al-Qaeda and ISIS and the Haqqani network and the Pakistan Taliban and the Afghan Taliban and several other groups that are at work there. And they're working in an area that has two-thirds of the world's cultivatable land under poppy production. So it's really the breadbasket of the world for drug production, and it's also where some of the worst terror groups in the world are located. So it makes sense that you have this symbiotic relationship between drug traffickers and between the terrorists who are there. It's really their number one source of income.
Wow, fascinating. Jeffrey Higgins, thank you so much for shedding some light for us all. We look forward to seeing the episode tonight. It's Declassified. It airs right here on CNN coming up next.